The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I am Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. This is your channel. Here we give you all authentic and verified, simplified medical explanations about the most common healthcare topics from verified newest National Medical Library. And today we are going to talk about hernia. Hernia is one of the most common problems seen in adult life as well as in children. Very commonly, these people go for surgeries without knowing what caused the problem, what is the problem. So let's talk something about hernia. Hernia is a sac basically formed by the lining of the abdominal cavity. That's the most common site of hernia, abdominal cavity, which is also called, the lining is also called peritoneum. So abdominal cavity or abdomen has peritoneum as a lining, and this lining becomes comes out, the lining, this basically becomes a sac coming through a hole or a weak area in the strong layers of the belly, of the wall of your abdomen, right? That surrounds the muscle, right? So this layer of the abdomen which is surrounding a muscle is called fascia. Fascia is a fibrous layer. So there can be a hole, a weakness, or a little bifurcation from where the internal peritoneum can actually bulge out, the sac can come out, right? This type of hernia, there can be many types of this hernia, and this hernia depends upon where it is, right? It can be down below your femoral area, just above your thighs. Femoral area, there will be a bulge in the upper thigh, just below the groin, and this type is more common in women as compared to men. Hiatal hernia, which you've seen, it occurs in the upper part of the stomach, and part of that upper stomach actually pushes from the diaphragm into the chest. That's why these people have gastroesophageal reflux problem, hiatus hernia problem. There can be something called as incisional hernia. Say you have had an operation, abdominal surgery, and because of that incision, the fascia or the muscles have become weak, and from that weak part, if the stitches are not done properly, or sometimes if you stretch or cuff during the healing time, because of that increased pressure, that fascia can separate, and it can lead to a sac formation of your peritoneum coming through that sac outside, and it causes a hernia. It basically, you can say it is through a scar if you have had abdominal surgery in the past. All right, then incisional, then umbilical hernia. Umbilical hernia is the bulge which is around the belly button, right? It occurs when the muscles around the belly button, they does not close completely after the birth. So that is a congenital type of problem. Then there is something called inguinal hernia, which is also very common. This is a bulge in the groin region, proper groin. Below the groin is femoral, proper groin is inguinal hernia. It is more common in men, and it actually may all the way go down into the scrotum. Yes, it can go, there is an inguinal canal. So it can go through the canal into the scrotum. Or there are two types of inguinal hernia, direct and indirect. Indirect, it actually pierces the canal from middle, and indirect, it goes properly from the canal, right? So that is what hernias, types of hernias are. Then what is the cause basically, right? Obviously, the cause is weakness in this abdominal covering areas, the fascias and muscles, sometimes because of surgery, sometimes because of incision, sometimes congenital, sometimes because of lifestyle problems, like sometimes because of heavy lifting. Increased pressure can lead to, you know, hernia, straining while you are passing your stools, while toilet, toileting, you can actually have increased intra-abdominal pressure, because of which you can have hernia, or any kind of activity that actually increases the pressure inside the abdomen, right? Pushing or anything, right? So those can actually lead to hernia if you have weakness there anywhere, right? So hernias can also be present from birth, right? But the bulge may not be evident until sometime later in life. So it's possible that you have a hole inside the abdomen, but it might bulge later when you start lifting heavy weights. So that's also possible. So some people have this kind of issue. Some people even have a family history of hernia, right? There also some genetic factor is also there. Then babies and children can also get hernias, and it happens when there is some weakness in the belly wall. Obviously, I've told you that inguinal hernias are common in young boys, right? Some children actually do not have any problem until they are adults. Sometimes this happens, and any problem, any activity which you do, which you feel increases the hernia or it leads to any discomfort or pain, you should actually talk to your doctor. And there are certain activities which actually lead to increased problems, like if chronic coughing, sneezing. Coughing and sneezing increases the abdominal pressure. Then long-term chronic constipation, right? Pushing hard during bowel movements, right? Then there is enlarged prostate problem, which leads to straining in urination. If you have a lot of weight, then you are carrying a lot of pressure in the abdomen, and carrying extra weight is just like lifting extra weight, right? That much weight you are carrying on your body. And if you have a lot of fluid inside the abdomen, ascites, if you have cystic fibrosis, connective tissue disorders from congenital, this is a connective tissue disorder basically. If you have poor nutrition, if you smoke, then also you increase your chances of hernia. Peritoneal dialysis, you know, when you actually do dialysis, it's a type of dialysis where you actually take out fluid from the peritoneum and replace it from the other side. Peritoneal dialysis is also done. Then overexertion can also increase your chances. And even undescended testes, if because of some reason your testicles are not descended, then also you have chances of hernia. So if you do have hernia, usually you might have no symptoms, and some people may have some discomfort or pain, but this discomfort may worsen only when you are straining or maybe sometimes standing or lifting heavy objects, right? But in time, most common complaint is basically just a bump, or that is little sore or is growing, sometimes in the umbilicus, sometimes groin, sometimes below the groin. That is the areas where hernias occur. And the typical thing is when you touch it, it actually bulges when you're coughing, right? So when a hernia gets bigger, it may get stuck inside that hole also, right? This is a problem. And if it gets stuck inside that hole, cannot come back, then it can actually lose its blood supply. This part can lose its blood supply, and this is called strangulation, kind of a hanging of that part, right? Strangulation, this causes extreme pain at the site of strangulation. This will also lead to sometimes nausea, vomiting, and not being able to even pass gas or have any stool movement. This will lead to an emergency, and you will need a surgery. Urgent surgery will be needed right away. Right, strangulation, hernia, you know, hernia which cannot be retracted, or strangulated hernia has to be ruled out. Okay, so how can you do that? How can you rule out? How do you examine? What are the tests? Right, your doctor can provide a lot of simple tests, can actually see and feel a hernia when you come to them, and just by doing that, just by asking you to cough, right, bend or push or lift something, if that hernia actually gets bigger, then it's a hernia, right? It's basically cuff test, cuff reflex, whatever you say. Then this bulge may not be easily seen if it is in children or infants, except when the child is crying or coughing, right? Also, sometimes nothing else is needed. Sometimes you can do an ultrasound or a CT scan just to look for hernias also, right? That also done. Then if there is a blockage in the bowels, if there is a blockage in the bowel, then an X-ray of the abdomen will be likely, will be done to see if there is, you know, if there is any blockage. Then treatment, how do you treat it? Hernia. Only treatment is surgery. Surgery is the only treatment which can permanently fix a hernia, because it's basically an opening, it's a broken window, it's something broken thing, a broken shirt has to be stitched, right? You cannot apply anything else, it has to be stitched. A broken part, a weak spot has to be surgically corrected, right? So surgery may be sometimes more risky in some people with serious medical conditions, but surgical repairs, basically they are aimed to repair the weakened abdominal wall tissue, the fascia, and close any holes which are already there. And most hernias are very easily closed with stitches, and sometimes we have to put a mesh over the stitch it, and then put a mesh over it just to be sure that it does not reoccur. Okay, so in the case of umbilical hernia, which actually does not heal on its own, if it is a child, then we can actually wait till the child is 5 years old, and if it does not repair by itself, then we have to do the surgery in that case also. The outcome is very nice, don't worry, it's very good. Surgery is a small surgery, rarely after surgery's hernia will come back, very very rarely, that's very rare. Incisional hernia, on the other hand, are very likely to return. If already incision has happened, stitches were made and it came back, then it might come back again, because it might be because of some chronic problem, some very weak abdominal wall, right? Then incisional hernia is only which comes back, nothing, others don't actually come back. Then in rare cases, inguinal hernia repair can actually damage some in function structures involving the functions of the testicles, right? So it's very rare, but surgery is very safe, but rarely some complications can happen. So another risk of surgery is nerve damage, which can actually lead to numbness in the groin area, and sometimes if there is a bowel part which is trapped, strangulated hernia is there, then the bowel, then the intestine can actually get perforated, or the bowel may die inside the strangulation, and then at that point the bowel has to be removed, part of bowel have to be removed and sutured again. So that can be the complicated hernia situation. Right. So if you have a painful hernia or a swelling which just really reacts to coughing, bulges and comes back again, if you have nausea, vomiting, painful hernias, anything like a red, purple, dark, discolored hernia, it's an MR that can be strangulated, right? Just go to a surgeon, let them examine, and they will let you know whether it is a hernia or not. So the big question comes, how can you prevent hernia? Can you prevent hernia? Yes, you can. Number one, use proper lifting techniques. Lose weight. If you are overweight, you have to lose weight. That will help a lot, because a lot of weight will actually loosen your tissues, right? Then you have to control or relieve, avoid constipation, right? You have to avoid constipation by eating a lot of fiber, drinking a lot of water, going to the bathroom as soon as you have the urge, and exercising regularly. I've made a different video on constipation, don't forget to watch that. And as in case of men, they should see their doctor if they start straining with urination for an enlarged prostate, and they should get that problem solved as soon as possible. So this is all about hernia, which you need to know, or which is there to be told. So hope this information was good. Hope you liked the video. If you did, then don't forget to share this video and give me a big thumbs up. It feels really awesome to have the number of likes. All right, I'm Dr. Paramjit. You're watching Dr. Education. Stay connected. Stay healthy.